have a BDS 3-inch suspension lift kit here. We're going to be putting this on a Ram 2500. We're going to be putting the 3-inch suspension system on because this is a work truck, so we're going to have to be getting in and out of the back of the bed and using it to work every day. So we don't want to go any bigger than that. We're going to go over what's included in this BDS suspension system. You have your upper and lower control arms, your bushings, your rear blocks, sway bar end links, your 3-inch springs, your adjustable track bar, your stainless steel braided brake lines, and we upgraded to Fox shocks. We're going to go ahead and start putting our suspension system on. We're going to start in the rear of our truck. Chalk your front tires. You're going to want to jack the truck up, put a jack stand right in front of the hanger for the leaf springs. Take your wheels off. We're going to go ahead and install our block. You're going to want to use new U-bolts. You don't want to reuse the old ones. Going to have to undo our emergency brake line. You're going to want to reroute that through your spring hanger so it'll give you more drop with your springs. Before we go ahead and install our new lift block, you're going to go ahead and remove your rear shocks. Then we're going to put our block in and we're going to use our new U-bolts. Get your U-bolts out, you're going to want to lower your axle. Before you put the new block in, there's a plastic pin in the center of your leaf spring. You're going to want to remove that. You're going to put in the new metal pin. This is going to line up with your block when you put your block in. Also, when you put your block in, it's tapered. So make sure you install your block the correct way. Bigger in the back, smaller on the front. Once you get your blocks in, you get your U-bolts all put in, you're gonna torque your U-bolts down to 125 foot-pounds. Gonna go ahead and install your shocks on the rear. We upgraded our shocks to the Fox 2.0s. Now that you have the rear of your truck all wrapped up, you're going to go ahead and move to the front. First step is going to be remove your factory track bar and retain all the hardware. You're going to need that later. Then you're going to jack your vehicle up, set it on jack stands, make sure to chock your rear tire. We're going to go ahead and take off our brake line bracket and then move to disconnecting our sway bars. We're going to go ahead and loosen up the hardware on your control arms, upper and lower arm. Then the upper bolt for the upper control arm at the frame is going to have the bolt head cut off to remove it. There's new hardware included for that. Before you put your arms in, you're going to have to add the bushings and the sleeves. 2010 and newer is going to use the 18 millimeter sleeve at the axle. Put some soap on a towel. After you go ahead and get the bolt cut off on the passenger side upper arm, you're going to remove those control arms and put the new BDS arms in. We've already did that on that side, so now we're going to go ahead and remove our stock arms and put in our BDS arms. Once you have your upper and lower control arms on, the next step, you're going to go ahead and remove the lower and upper hardware for your shock. That way you're going to be able to drop your axle. You can pull your coil spring out and get ready to put your new shock and coil spring in. Before you go ahead and put your coil springs in, there's a small area on the factory track bar bracket that you're going to have to trim. There's a template that comes with the kit. You're going to want to use that template to mark out the area and trim the small area that's trimmed. after you've cut the small area on your track bar, you can go ahead and start installing your coil springs and your shocks. Again, we upgraded to the Fox shocks on our kit. You're gonna put the bushings in your sway bar end links. You're gonna use the longer sleeve for the bottom. You're gonna put this little spacer over it. And attach it to the axle. You're gonna take the clevis mount and mount that to your sway bar. Then slide your sway bar end link up, pull your sway bar down, and attach it. Put our adjustable track bar in now. You're going to want to adjust it and measure 39 and an eighth before you put it on. Once you get your wheels and all on your truck and you get it set down on the ground, you're going to want to go ahead and torque down your control arm. Just remember, they were just tightened up during installation. Now that we've done all that, we have our wheels tightened down and everything, torqued to spec, we're going to go ahead and install our dual steering stabilizer that we got from BDS as well. This is the finished product of our BDS suspension. Make sure that you've went through and torqued everything down after installation. You're going to want to go back through and re-torque everything and check it after about 500 miles. We've got a set of wheels coming and tires for this truck, so as soon as they get in, we'll put those on and we'll be done with our build. This is our 3-inch BDS lift. We finally have our wheels and tires put on. We went with BMF wheels. We run a TOYO Open Country 8T. It's a 275-6520. We went with this setup on our truck because it's going to be a work truck. We're going to want to be able to keep it functional throughout the day with pulling trailers and working in and out of the back of the truck.